You're awesome, Meaty Grind fans. Fuck you. Yeah.
And now, an interview with a hot girl who does stuff on the internet.
This is a hot chick that does stuff online.
Greg Burke
did this.
Why did we take the clothes?
Why did we do this?
There's so much blood.
Can you tell the audience a little bit of what we just saw?
You guys just saw Wolverine's Claws Suck, and it's a video about two dudes who want to get superhero powers, and they have to choose. They only have enough money for either the Wolverine's claws or his mutant healing. And as you can see, you can't really get the claws without the mutant healing.
How did you get started doing Greg and Lou?
How did I get started doing Greg and Lou? Well, we were in a group called the Hammer Cats back at NYU.
Okay.
And in the Hammer Cats were a couple of other internet groups, Derek Comedy, who has like Donald Glover from Community. And so we all started together at NYU in this big group called the Hammer Cats.
Wow.
And then from NYU, we started performing at the UCB Theater in New York.
Okay.
And then we realized, oh shit, there's 10 of us and there's just not enough stage time for everyone.
Oh.
So we all broke off into like three different groups. Derek Comedy, Chubby Skinny Kids, and then Greg and Lou.
So far, what's been your favorite sketch that you guys have done?
Oh, Die Hard. We did a Die Hard parody, and like my idol growing up was Bruce Willis.
Wow.
So I got to do John McClane, so that was pretty great.
If you met Bruce Willis, and you only could say one thing to him, what would you say?
Come out to the coast, make a few drinks, have a few laughs. I don't know, his line from the beginning, I don't know.
Awesome.
I guess the Bruce Willis is basically, ba-ba-da-ban, da-ba-da-ban, ba-ba-da-ban, da-ba-da-ban. That's how you do Bruce Willis.
That's it.
Yeah. So I would just do my shitty impression back to him. And then he would look at me really weird and just slowly walk away. And that would be all I needed.
And that would be it.
Yeah.
But what if he loved it? What if he was like, come be my son?
Oh shit, I would be his son.
Okay. You've been acting for a very long time.
I have. I was a child actor.
Okay. How did you get started? Were your parents like, oh, he's cute, let's put him in stuff?
Yeah.
Really?
Basically, my mom thought I was cute. And I was like 4 years old, and I started doing like JCPenney print ads.
Oh.
And then I moved on.
Back in the 80s?
Back in the 80s, yeah. That's right. I was a really cute kid. And then I started doing commercials, and I was on a soap opera for 5 years.
Wow.
As a teenager.
How was that, growing up, sort of having that experience?
Weird. I got made fun of a lot in junior high school.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I would think that like kids would be like, oh, that's so cool, you're on TV. But no. They were like, no, it's not cool, you're on TV.
Yeah.
Aww.
Like, fuck you. Also, it was Staten Island, New York, so it's a lot of like, what the fuck are you doing? You think you're better than me?
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's a lot of that.
What was your favorite experience that you had as a kid when you were, you know, sort of all involved?
I also did a bunch of SNLs when I was a kid, like the kid in the sketch. I would be like one of the kids in the sketch.
Oh, that's rad.
So I was on the episode where they had the first Five Timers Club. So they had like Steve Martin back, Paul Simon was there, and like it was when Tom Hanks was inducted into the Five Timers Club. So it was like 1990, I think.
So you were a kid and you got to meet these
I got all their autographs on like a yellow pad piece of paper.
Where is that yellow pad?
It's behind a picture, a signed autograph picture of Alan Alda that's in my bedroom. Because I was an extra on a Woody Allen movie when I was like 5 that Alan Alda was in. And I didn't know who Alan Alda was, my mom did. And she pushed me up to him and said, Alan Alda, can you please sign this picture for me?
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I want that now.
No, you can't have it.
Okay.
My mom sleeps with it every night.
If you couldn't be an actor,
right?
What would you do instead?
I would be a failed baseball player.
Really?
Yes. Oh, failed. You think I'd be successful?
Well, maybe.
No.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm not.
I was really good. I was really good in Little League in high school, and then I blew out my shoulder. I was a pitcher, and I tore my rotator cuff.
Oh no!
Yeah.
I mean, if you were a failed baseball player, like, would you be like Ted Danson in like Cheers?
Oh wow, that would be fucking amazing if I was Ted Danson. I guess I would become like a bartender or something.
You'd like own a bar.
Well, I don't know if I have enough money to own a bar. How did he own a bar as a failed? Well, no.
I think he made money.
He did. He was a baseball player. He made it.
He was
and
a
then
pitcher. He was amazing.
He was on the Red Sox for a while.
Right.
That makes sense. I would not have made it to any team in the major leagues. So I would have been like the bar back at his bar.
Okay.
That's what
you would have been Woody.
I would have been Woody. Yeah, that's fine. Woody's okay. Awesome.
What's your favorite kind of meat?
My favorite kind of meat, I guess, is pepperoni.
So if you had a dream role, what would your dream role be?
I guess to be in a movie like Die Hard, where I was the star of like an action movie that was like a gritty, like the first Die Hard is an amazing movie.
Right.
He's just like a normal guy stuck in a really shitty situation.
Totally.
So if I could be like that, not like Rambo or something, but like a crazy, like a New York City cop stuck in LA, California. If I could be that, that would be pretty awesome.
So you want to shoot guns is what you're saying.
I want to shoot guns.
And like be badass and like run around.
Right.
Maybe with a baseball bat.
That'd be cool too. Oh shit, if I took out terrorists with like just like hitting baseballs at them, that'd be great. That's gritty realistic, right? That would happen.
That would be a fantastic like sort of quasi superhero.
Yeah, I guess.
You just carry around a bag of balls. And
that's like Casey Jones though from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, just with a hockey stick and pucks.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Except you would be ballsy.
Ballsy Casey at the Bat Jones.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Greg.
Yes.
Hot meat of the week.
Yeah.
Ariel Castro.
What?
Bombings.
Zelda.
America's Tokyo.
Something I would never do.
Chuck Ramsey.
Cannot be a real person.
Carnival cruise ships.
Boop. That's gotta be an answer you get a lot, right? Boop.
That was the hot meat of the week.
Hot meat of the week.
Yeah.
You know what you got there? You got some hot meat.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning into my interview with...
Greg Burke.
I'm your host, Sarah Fletcher. This is The Meaty Grind. Make sure to check out our new content on Tuesdays. Make sure to check out his content, Greg and Lou. Again, this is...
Greg Burke.
And remember what Mama says.
I'm sorry, but Ellen DeGeneres is funny. Follow your dreams if you want to play baseball. Don't use that. That's awful. Don't use that.
Say that again.
Skip
that
right now. Follow your dreams if you want to play baseball.